The fight for Juicy committees erupted in Parliament today as members of Parliament were being designated, to the extent that the FDC camp exchanged verbal insults with the party whip Semuju Nganda. Some FDC members accused Semuju Nganda of using his committee positions to punish those who did not support his speakership bid. The 29 committees of Parliament were constituted today. Our reporter has the details.
We know you've not been here, but with the rules of procedure and the constitution that we are giving you, we believe you'll be able to do your work as required by this parliament.
Today, Parliament, chaired by the Deputy Speaker, Anita Mongin, sought to constitute parliamentary committees, and it started by passing a motion to vary the number of MPs who subscribe to committees from 30 each to accommodate more members. As Government Chief Whip Thomas Tayewa, Chief Opposition Chief Whip John Baptist Nambesha, the Acting Dean of Independence David Livingstone, and Dean of the UPDF MPs Charity Binababo designated members to particular standing and sectorial committees. Some MPs were shocked to find themselves in committees which are contrary to the choices they applied for, and they went up in arms.
Not stop me from being in any committee, even if I'm not a member. So I think I'll continue to sit in the budget committee.
The Honorable Cecily Ogwal served on the budget committee for 5 years. Why didn't she complain then? Today I am designating her to committee on rules. Let me tell you, in this parliament, the most important committee which acts as a court is the committee on rules, discipline and privileges.
I am extremely disappointed the way our whips are designating members in the various committee. We are totally disappointed. Like for us in FDC, the parliamentary rule of procedure states clearly that a member will express his or her interest in the committee where he or she is competent in. But for our disappointment, our chief whip, Semuju Nganda, he takes you and throw you to any committee.
The Dokolo District Woman Member of Parliament, Cecilia Ogwal, and Clark South MP Gilbert Solanya turned guns against the FDC Chief Whip Ibrahim Semuju Nganda and castigated him for disappointing their applications to sit on committees of their choice. But Semuju retaliated in equal measure.
As I talk now, 90% of the FDC members of Parliament are not satisfied at all on these allocations by Honorable Semuju Nganda. So I do not know why he's behaving in this way. And I don't know even how Semuju Nganda came to be our chief whip.
When you apply, it means I'll designate you minding many other factors. The Honorable Anya, I am the one who designated him to committee on defense for 5 years. Now I have changed him. I want him also to have experience in fighting HIV/AIDS. I don't know why he's not happy.
Ogwal, who has served on the Committee of Budget for a long time, had applied to be retained. Dolanya had expressed interest to sit on the Local Government Accounts Committee, but found himself on the Committee of HIV and AIDS. The two accused Semuju for using his role as a whip to revive their conflicts in the speakership race where FDC members abandoned him for Kadaga.
It is very clear that he's a member of the party, and it's very clear that he stood to be the Speaker of Parliament, and it's very clear that he got, I don't know whether 15 votes, but there are 32 members of FDC.
Maybe I am thinking he is trying to bring in what happens during the speakership election. He is trying to transfer that aggression, he is trying to transfer that annoyance onto the committee work, which is very nonsense. Automatically is going to disorganize our work as FDC on the floor of Parliament.
I am doing my work as FDC whip to assign MPs to committees. I cannot determine how they are going to interpret that assignment.
Ogwal wondered how Semuju dropped her from the budget committee with her all expertise she has in the field of economics and replaced her with himself, whose expertise is in journalism.
I know that you don't have to be a professional person in order to be in some of those committees, but he decided to designate himself in the budget. So that already shows some conflict of interest. That is the only thing which makes me uncomfortable.
I sit on the committee on rules. Am I a lawyer? Why doesn't she complain that a journalist is sitting on a committee on rules? So you see, committees, the party has a reason why it appointed me a supervisor. And I respect people that I am supervising, but I must also respect the decision of their supervisor. Otherwise, you will have no supervisor and people to supervise.
Not only FDC members are bickering. Some NUP members, like Paul Nsubuga, whose choice for Committee of Education and Sports was not considered, has no kind words for the party whip.
The first committee, I'm contented, government assurances. But the other sectoral committee, I'm not contented. Why? If I apply on sports, you can count 1, 2, 3, 4 MPs here in Parliament. There is no MP who is much in love with sports like Honorable Nsubuga Paul. So when you allocate me to another committee, which I don't understand, that means I'll not deliver.
However, many legislators are proud with the committee choices they were allocated and they have committed to serve.
On the Human Rights Committee, and you are aware that I'm a victim of torture. I've been in Chitalia prison. I was badly beaten. I was badly tortured. Even ended up in Nairobi Hospital. So if I'm on this committee, I will duly exercise my freedom. I will duly fight for the rights of prisoners.
I'm comfortable with the committees because they're in line with my work, which is the legal work. And you know, legal work is national in nature. It touches everyone. When the law is respected everywhere, everyone enjoys the country. So I'm happy that I'm on these legal committees because it falls within my domain, because I've been fighting for the rights of the people.
Parliament has 29 committees with 13 standing and 16 sectarial committees. Although MPs are designated by their party whips, they are given a chance to express interest for committees of their choices. Story by Fred Kajubi for the news in Parliament.